Okay, so welcome back, everybody. So I am Nicolas Burke, and I will be the moderator for this talk. And so it is my pleasure and great honor to welcome for this talk Alexander Nazarov from the State University of St. Petersburg, and he will speak about variety of fractional Laplacians. Alexander, you can start.
Okay, thank you for the introduction. And I would like to say that this talk is a great honor for me, and it's a great pity for me. It's a great honor to give a talk at the Congress, and it's a great pity that this Congress is not in St. Petersburg. Let me share my screen and let's start. Fractional Laplacians and equations with them have been actively studied in last decades in various fields of mathematics, analysis, PDEs, random processes theory, and so on, and also in applications such as physics, biology, etc. Hundreds of articles have been written on this topic. These operators are non-local, but their study is complicated not only by non-locality itself, but also by existence of several non-equivalent definitions of fractional Laplacians. Surely there exist Dirichlet, Neumann, and other fractional Laplacians, but even, for example, for the Dirichlet, we can define restricted, spectral, and some other types. Historically, the first fractional Laplacian was the fractional Laplacian of positive order in the whole space. It is defined via the Fourier transform as follows. And for the order between 0 and 1, we can also express this operator via the hypersingular integral, as is written here. We recall the definitions of classical Sobolev-Slobodetsky spaces in the whole space. They are defined in terms of the Fourier transform again, and corresponding spaces in a domain. We will use the space HS and H tilde S. And the quadratic form of the fractional Laplacian in the whole space is naturally defined via this formula on the Sobolev-Slobodetsky space in Rn. In what follows, we denote by parentheses the duality generated by the scalar product in L2. Now we define the restricted Dirichlet fractional Laplacian. It is a positive self-adjoint operator. Its quadratic form is the same as in the whole space, but the domain is just the space of functions supported in omega bar. In fact, if you wish, you can imagine that all functions which I'm talking about are smooth and compactly supported in omega. For s between 0 and 1, this quadratic form again can be written as follows. Look here, the integral is over Rn times Rn. In what follows, all things related to the restricted Dirichlet operator will be colored in teal. For s between 0 and 1, one can also define the restricted Neumann fractional Laplacian. It is also called regional fractional Laplacian. By this quadratic form, you can see here integral over omega times omega. And surely there exist intermediate fractional Laplacians of this type. Now we turn to so-called spectral fractional Laplacians. The spectral Dirichlet and spectral Neumann fractional Laplacians are simply the powers of conventional Dirichlet and Neumann Laplacians in the sense of spectral theory. In a domain omega, they can be defined as self-adjoint operators with the following quadratic forms. Here, lambda j and phi j are eigenvalues and eigenfunctions of the Dirichlet Laplacian, and mu j and psi j, respectively, of Neumann Laplacian. And you see here that the summation is from zero, but in fact, the zeros term is zero because of this relation. And in what follows, all things related to the spectral Dirichlet will be colored in red, and with the spectral Neumann will be colored in magenta. I point out that for the order between 0 and 1, the domains of these quadratic forms are just our spaces of Sobolev-Slobodetsky in omega, h tilde and h respectively. For s greater than 1, the domains are more complicated, but they always contain the space h tilde, as it is written on the right. And for small s, they coincide with h tilde. The well-known Heinz inequality shows that for arbitrary u in h tilde, and s between 0 and 1, the following inequality holds. So this quadratic form Dirichlet is greater or equal than this quadratic form Neumann spectral. And the same inequality holds for a restricted quadratic form, but in this case it is trivial. And now I recall some basic facts on the generalized harmonic extensions related to fractional Laplacians of the order between 0 and 1 and of the negative order between minus 1 and 0. It was known long ago that the square root of Laplacian is related to the harmonic extension and to classical Dirichlet to Neumann map. But Caffarelli and Sylvester in 2007, in the breakthrough paper, showed that for arbitrary sigma between 0 and 1, the fractional Laplacian in the whole space, and therefore the Dirichlet restricted fractional Laplacian is related in the same way to the generalized harmonic extension and to the generalized Dirichlet to Neumann map. Namely, let U be in this space, then we consider the following boundary value problem in the half space. You see here this equation for sigma equals 1/2. It is just the Laplace equation in the half space. And this boundary condition for W, so the W is harmonic extension in for sigma 1/2, and in general case it is called generalized harmonic extension. There exists a unique solution which we denote in this way, which has finite energy. And the energy, I will always call energy the weighted Dirichlet integral of this type. And the following relation holds in the sense of distributions and also point-wise at every point of smoothness of original function U. For sigma equal to 1/2, we have here just the normal derivative, and we obtain the standard Dirichlet to Neumann map. Moreover, this extension minimizes this energy over the set of all admissible extensions. And the quadratic form of Dirichlet restricted Laplacian is up to a constant equal to the minimal energy. Three years later, in the paper of Stinger and Terea, this approach was substantially generalized. In particular, for U in H tilde for the case of Dirichlet, and for U in HS, H sigma in the case of Neumann, there is a unique solution of the following boundary value problem. It is quite similar to the previous one, but it is not in the half space, it is in the half cylinder. On the bottom, we have the same boundary condition. And on the lateral surface of the half cylinder, we have respectively Dirichlet or Neumann boundary condition. There is a unique solution having finite energy. I will call this energy spectral one, and you see here that integral is over half cylinder, and the previous one was over the half space. I will denote these solutions as follows. And a similar relation hold again in the sense of distributions in omega, and also point-wise and at the points of smoothness of original function U, that this fractional Laplacian and this fractional Laplacian is the Neumann data of for corresponding extension. Again, we obtain generalized Dirichlet to Neumann map. This extension minimize the spectral energy over corresponding sets, which are written here. And again, the following equalities hold. So the quadratic forms are up to the same constant equal to these minimal energies. Now we set S between minus one and zero, negative order. These three operators, minus sigma Dirichlet Laplacian, Dirichlet restricted, Dirichlet spectral, and Neumann spectral, they are defined by the same quadratic forms as the for the positive. Only the order is different. But the domains are written here. In fact, the domains are such that corresponding quadratic forms are well defined. I should stress that the Neumann spectral negative operator is defined up to an additive constant. But this constant can be naturally fixed by the assumption that the image is orthogonal to constants. I skip here some technical details, but I emphasize that the restricted Dirichlet negative operator is not inverse to the restricted Dirichlet positive operator, whereas the spectral operator are inverse to corresponding positive operators. Next, we connect fractional Laplacians of the negative order with the generalized now Neumann to Dirichlet map. For the positive case, there was Dirichlet to Neumann, and here is Neumann to Dirichlet. It was done in the following papers for these three fractional Laplacians. Let U be in this negative space for dimension one and sigma greater or equal than one half. I assume in addition that U is orthogonal to constants. And we consider the following minimization problem. Here is the same restricted energy, and I stress that this duality is well defined for such U and W. W is in this set. This set is just the closure of smooth functions in the half space with bounded support and the closure with respect to the restricted energy. If n is greater than 2 sigma, it is not a restriction for n greater than 1, then the minimizer is determined uniquely. I denote it by a negative extension, Dirichlet restricted extension, and I obtain the following relations. The second one says that the result, the image, is up to a constant, just Dirichlet data of my extension, and it holds for arbitrary all x in omega. And the left one connects the quadratic form, negative quadratic form, with this functional. We can see that this quadratic form, again up to a constant, coincides with the minimal value of corresponding functional, but I stress that here you have the minus sign. It is very important. In the remaining case, the construction is similar, but more complicated. This function, in fact, solves the Neumann problem in the half space. So this is the same equation. And here is the Neumann boundary condition in the sense of distributions. So we can consider this negative operator as the Neumann to Dirichlet map. And this problem gives us the dual variational characterization of negative restricted Dirichlet fractional Laplacian. In a similar way, we can provide the dual variational characterization of negative spectral Dirichlet and Neumann operators. I again take U in the negative space, and for spectral Neumann, I assume this orthogonality condition and consider a similar problem with spectral energy, and I obtain some spectral negative functional on corresponding sets which are written here. I denote these minimizers as follows. And again, I omit some technical details, and the following relation hold. The right two right relations hold almost everywhere in omega. And again, I emphasize minus signs here on the left. The functions W minus sigma solve the similar boundary value problem in the half cylinder. On the bottom, you have Neumann boundary condition. And on the lateral surface, we have correspondingly Dirichlet or Neumann boundary conditions. And now I can formulate the first group of our results, namely comparison of fractional Laplacians in the sense of quadratic form. Let S be greater than minus one and non-integer. Suppose that U is not zero. For negative S, I again need some orthogonality conditions to have all quadratic forms well defined. In fact, the domains of quadratic forms are different, and we take U in the smallest one. Then, three of these quadratic forms, Dirichlet spectral, Neumann spectral, and Dirichlet restricted, are ordered. And they are ordered depending on the parity of the integer part of S. For the integer orders, all three quadratic forms coincide for such U. But for non-integer orders, I can say that they jump over each other, as is shown in this picture. Here, Neumann spectral is the greatest, Dirichlet spectral is the smallest. Here, vice versa, and here again, and so on. As if playing leapfrog. For the proof, we proceed in three steps. First of all, let S between 0 and 1. Then we can assume any function in the any extension in Dirichlet spectral to be extended by zero. It is originally defined in the half cylinder, but we can extend it by zero to the whole half space. Then evidently this set of extensions is smaller than this set of extensions, and corresponding energy restricted to a smaller space coincides with this energy. Now we have relations between quadratic form and energies. This quadratic form is equal up to a constant to the minimum of this energy. It is greater or equal than the minimum over the larger set. And this is just this quadratic form. So we obtain the first, the left inequality with the large sign. Why the sign is in fact strict? Because if u is not identically zero, then the corresponding extension, Dirichlet spectral extension extended by zero, cannot be a solution of a homogeneous equation in the whole half space, because such a solution is analytic in the half space. So it cannot provide this minimum, and the result is strict. The right inequality between Dirichlet restricted and Neumann spectral is in fact even more simple. For S between minus one and zero, we have the in fact the same relations, but the relation between energies, between these functionals and quadratic forms, they have minus sign. And just because of that, we obtain opposite inequalities. Finally, let S be greater than one. Then we apply some standard Laplacians to the function U. For example, if S is between 2 and 3, we take one Laplacian and come into the interval 0, 1. If S is between 3 and 4, we take two Laplacians and come into minus 1 and 0. Anyway, we obtain this order. These relations simply transfer our problem to the case as between minus one and zero, or between zero and one. And the result follows from the previous steps. And we are done. The second group of our results is related to the pointwise comparison of fractional Laplacians. Let S between zero be between zero and one, and U is non-negative and not identically zero. Then the following inequality holds in distribution, in the sense of distributions. So the difference of these two Laplacians, we know that it is positive in the sense of quadratic forms, but also it turns out that this difference is positivity preserving. For S negative between minus one and zero, or for N equal to one for in such interval, we have the opposite inequality. And finally, if omega is a convex domain, for S between 0 and 1, we have the same U, a similar inequality between these two fractional Laplacians. Well, for the proof, we introduce the difference between corresponding extensions. By the strong maximum principle, the assumption that U is non-negative and not identically zero imply that this extension, Dirichlet restricted extension, is strictly positive in the whole half space. The other restriction is zero on the lateral surface of half cylinder. So we have this inequality. And so the difference is positive, and on the bottom the difference is zero, so the difference is strictly positive in the whole half cylinder, again by the maximum principle. And now the relations between fractional Laplacians and Dirichlet-Neumann maps gives that this difference of fractional Laplacians is up to a constant. The generalized Neumann data for this function WS. If S is 1/2, WS is simply harmonic. And you have here the Neumann data, and the boundary point lemma says that it has sign, strict sign. In general, the proof is in fact the same, but uses a generalized form of the boundary point lemma by Kaminian and Himchenko. For negative S, the argument is the same, but there we have not Dirichlet to Neumann, but Neumann to Dirichlet map, and it gives us the opposite inequality. The statement C is more complicated. We take these representation formulas for our extensions. First of all, it is easy to see that if y, the variable y, tends to plus infinity, then the first formula gives us zero. And the second formula gives us this quantity, and it is positive. And next, on the lateral boundary of half cylinder, we calculate the normal derivative of this formula and obtain by convexity of omega that it is negative. And then the difference between these two extensions solves the same equation in the half cylinder and meets the following boundary conditions. Again, we have strong maximum principle. It is strictly positive in the half cylinder. It is just zero on the bottom, and the generalized boundary point lemma completes the proof. For non-convex domain, in general, this statement is not true. I provide corresponding counterexample. Temporarily, I take omega as a sum of two disjoint domains, and I take U greater or equal than zero, but it is a function, smooth, for example, function compactly supported in omega one. And then the spectral Neumann operator evidently vanishes in omega two. On the other hand, this dirichlet restricted extension is strictly positive in the whole half space, and the boundary point lemma says us that that in omega 2 this operator is negative. So we have opposite side. Okay, at the moment omega is not a domain, but I join now omega 1 and omega 2 by a small channel, and the same inequality holds by continuity. In fact, I conjecture that this statement fails in arbitrary non-convex domain, but at the moment it is only a conjecture. The last group of our results is related to an obvious identity, that the quadratic form of standard Laplacian is preserved if I replace a function u by its modulus. It turns out that for s between 0 and 1, all quadratic forms, which I mentioned, all four quadratic forms, diminish under this replacement. And for a sign-changing original function, all inequalities, in fact, are strict. First of all, I should say that for s between 0 and 1, including one, this Nemitsky operator is a continuous transform of the Sobolev-Slobodetsky space into itself. For the Dirichlet restricted quadratic form, there are several different proofs of this inequality. In particular, if we take its representation via hypersingular integral, then it is in fact evident. And this proof works also for restricted Neumann. But I show another proof which also works for spectral quadratic forms. Okay, let u be sign-changing. Then I take this extension and notice that its modulus belongs to the set of admissible extensions for the modulus of u. Then I have this quadratic form. It is equal to the minimal energy. It is less or equal than the energy of this function, but this energy is equal to this one because it is just weighted Dirichlet integral, and it is equal to the quadratic form up to the same constant. Yeah, and again we have the inequality with the large sign, but the equality is impossible by the same reason. This function cannot solve the homogeneous equation. Okay, but what it is in fact a simple statement. But what happens for s greater than one? If s is between 1 and 3/2, then this Nemitsky operator is a bounded transform of the Sobolev-Slobodetsky space into itself. And up to our knowledge, its continuity is still an open problem. Moreover, this boundary 3/2 cannot be improved. This means that the question about the behavior of quadratic forms under this transform, it is a reasonable question just for s between 1 and 3/2. And we have the following result. For such s, let u be sign-changing, then the restricted Dirichlet quadratic form grows under this replacement. So we again have an opposite inequality. This result was obtained using a quite non-trivial approximation procedure. We conjecture that similar inequalities should fulfill for all considered quadratic forms. The last but not least, I am deeply grateful to my friend and co-author, Professor Roberto Mussina, for many years of cooperation. In fact, without her, I could not even get started in this field. In this picture, we are in Peterhof, near the great Peterhof Palace. It is a suburb of St. Petersburg. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much for this very interesting talk, Alexander. So as we mentioned earlier, it is a real pity that there can be no questions for the talk, because everything is remote and it was not possible technically. But of course, if you have any question, you feel free to contact directly Alexander by email, and I'm pretty sure he will be more than happy to answer any questions you can have.
Definitely.
Okay, so thank you very much, Alexander.
Thank you, Nicholas, and thanks to all listeners.
Yes, absolutely. Thanks to the audience. And